Hey, what's up, guys? Coach Bobby here. Let's talk about why we train, all right? For all you young athletes out there, girls and boys, old athletes, girls and boys, adult, former, right, but always an athlete, athletes. Listen up, guys. We have to understand why we train, right? It does not make it easier, right? But it gives us a mindset that allows us to frame it the right way, all right? So for all you athletes out there who don't want to work out, who don't understand why you have to lift weights, why you have to run and do all that crap. Why am I running if I'm playing a sport like baseball? Why am I lifting if I'm playing a sport like basketball? Why am I doing all this stuff? Well, I'm gonna tell you why, guys. There are three reasons, right? Three reasons why we train, right? I want you guys to understand, remember, and then use this knowledge in your workout sessions as a reminder as to why you're doing what you're doing, okay? Number one, the most obvious reason why we train, why we work out is to get bigger, faster, stronger. That's easy, that's obvious. We lift weights to get stronger. We lift weights to get bigger. We run to get better lung capacity. We sprint to get faster. We do leg work to get explosive, to jump higher. Right? We do all those things to get bigger, faster, and stronger. That's number one. That's the most obvious. Okay, what's number two? Okay, since we're not powerlifters, most of us, since we're not in track and field, most of us, since we're not trying to be models, most of us, right? The reason we want to get bigger, faster, and stronger is so that we can play our sport more effectively. We can play our sport better. And more specifically, we want to get bigger, we want to get stronger, we want to get better lung capacity so that we can practice our sport longer with the right form, with the right technique. Okay, so we want to put in hours of work on our jump set, hours of work with our throwing motion, hours of work with our back pedal, hours of work with our swing. But we want those hours to be of good repetitions, of perfect form. That's only possible if we are conditioned enough to be able to do 100 jump shots with good form, to be able to do 100 swings with good form, to be able to back pedal for an hour with good form, right? So we want to get bigger and faster and stronger so that the repetitions we put into the building of our skills is all effective and efficient, right? You can do an hour of jump shots, an hour of batting practice, but if 45 minutes of that is in a tired, fatigued, weak state, those are not good repetitions. And so you're building bad muscle memory. You're building bad form into your hours. So you might say you've worked on your craft for 3 hours, but because you were not conditioned enough, strong enough, right, you couldn't do it correctly for long enough. Okay, so number one, bigger, faster, stronger. Number two, so that we can do our sport and practice our skills for longer, effectively. Now, number three, right, might be the most understood and underplayed reason we work out. Okay, there's a time, guys, in every game. There's a time in every meet, in every match, where you are confronted with a voice that wants you to quit, that wants you to stop, that says it's too hard. Right, I call that the I'm not going to quit muscle. There's a moment in the game, the fourth quarter they call it, where you want to give up, you want to go home, you want to stop playing. Only in the moments when we are tired and fatigued and don't want to do that last press on the bench press and don't want to do that last squat jump in our plyometric training and don't want to do that last lap in our running or that last sprint, only then can we work the muscle that we're going to need in the fourth quarter, that we're going to need in the bottom of the ninth inning. We can only work that I'm not going to quit muscle. We can only work that in the moments that we want to quit. So we train. The third reason is we train for mental toughness. We train to remind yourself who you are. We train so that in the moments when it's me against him, I know what I've done to get here. Did he do what I did to get here? And when you know that you've done what you need to do to be ready for the fourth quarter, you walk differently, right? You bounce differently. You go to the plate differently. You go to the free throw differently because you know you paid the price, right? That's the third reason for mental toughness, for working on that I'm not going to quit muscle that you know can only be worked in the moments you want to quit. So very simple, guys, when you're training, remember these three reasons why you're doing what you're doing. Number one, the easiest, everybody does that, bigger, faster, stronger. But number two, remember why you're getting bigger, faster, stronger, so that now you can do all the skills you do in practice, you can do them correctly for longer to perfect those skills. And then lastly, we're trying to get mentally tough. We're trying to be better in the fourth quarter here than our opponents are. All right, guys, so the next time you're working out, the next time your coach says one more sprint or one more set, remember why we're doing it. All right, guys, I love you guys. I'll talk to you next time.
I'm getting better than yesterday. I started off as a featherweight. Mayweather head, think I'm Major Payne. Damon Wayans with an ankle sprain. I'm getting better than yesterday. Got no excuses, I make a way. Whether I'm losing or gaining games, I'm never losing, I'm gaining games.